Representative Daley, we're sitting down about a week after that you voted no on the House Republicans' proposed state budget. So the budget right now, as we're taping, is kind of in limbo. But again, you could not give your support to that proposal, namely because of what you saw or did not see when it comes to education funding. So first, what were your warning signals? What were your red flags when you look at that proposal?
The red flags actually came from looking at the prior budgets and seeing that there were cuts of up to $1 billion for public school education. And so in looking at this budget, there was an increase, but an increase of $100 million. And so that doesn't really seem adequate when you look at the cost of education and the need for education. My own view is that education is an investment in our future, in our children, and that it's one of the most vital and important things that the state does, and that the budget tells the story of what the priorities are.
Sure.
And even with that increase, it doesn't go far enough.
Sure. We're going to look closely at your area, geographically, what you're looking at, but just want to pull something out. What you said about $1 billion worth of cuts you're looking at over the past 2 years, mm-hmm. with a proposal of only $100 million. I know billions and millions sometimes get thrown out there, but $1 billion compared to $100 million, that just seems like a drop in the bucket.
It is. So a drop in the bucket is exactly the right way to describe it. So what I'm seeing in my district is that while the per student cuts aren't really that large, we also have very well funded and extremely wonderful public schools. And the residents support these and pay for them with their property taxes. But then when you think about property taxes, you understand that those on fixed incomes, especially our seniors, are really affected by the property taxes. And, you know, at the same time that we have wonderful school districts, we also have food banks and community assistance programs. My district office spends a lot of time helping people with LIHEAP applications and property tax rebate applications. So, you know, the property taxes affect our seniors and our residents. Maybe not as much as in other districts.
And all that stems from school district funding.
It has ripple effects throughout your district.
It does have ripple effects. And I should also just mention that two of my municipalities border on the city of Philadelphia. And when I look at the city of Philadelphia, their per student cut is about $1,200 per student per year. And with what they're spending, that's not big. And I look at that as that can have an effect on my districts because we're neighbors. We shop, we have people go into work, they go to the sports events, cultural events, and it's a neighbor to us. And what happens with, you know, the schools in that district really can have an effect on what happens in Montgomery County.
So even though there's lines drawn, there's borders drawn, there's still what affects that transcends both ways.
It absolutely does. It absolutely does. So, you know, in voting for the budget, I had to look at those proximities and the whole big picture, and it just didn't cut the mustard.
So I'm sure that you will be following this education funding throughout the process. Is that as we're taping this, the budget is in the Senate's hands.
That's right.
It'll come back to the House at some point. So you will continue, I'm sure, to update us on the progress of education funding in the 2013-2014
state budget. We will do that. Thank you.